listen to the rest when you're rocking with the best. Stereo love, stereo love. Stereo. Give me some of that stereo love. Stereo love, stereo love. Give me some of that stereo love. Stereo love, stereo love. Give me some of that stereo love. Stereo love, stereo love. Give me some of that stereo love. Baby, listen to the beat go. Now let's make our bodies flow. Listen to the sound while you're moving up and down on me. On me. We're gonna listen to the stereo and do it all night long to our favorite song, girl. Taking my time, girl. Hit you with this bass line. Ooh, now catch this hook line. Stereo love, stereo love. Give me some of that stereo love. Stereo love, stereo love. Give me some of that stereo love. I'm sorry if I come across rude, but I'm just gonna tell you what we're about to do. Girl, I wanna give it to you twice. Spice it up, nice it up, tossing it up while I put it down. Real soft music, moving to it. Love the way it makes me do it. Ooh, baby, baby, love the way you drive me crazy. All I really want is your stereo love.
Stereo love, stereo love.
Give me that stereo.
Give me some of that stereo love.
Give me that stereo love.
There you have it, guys. This has been an unboxing of my new Graphtec vinyl cutter, CE7000 professional cutter, plotter, whatever you want to call it. But I just want to get a commercial grade. I wanted to get a commercial grade cutter so I can use it, get familiar with it, and show you guys how to use it just in case you think it might be something that you want for your business. If you're doing vinyl, if you're cutting vinyl seriously, consistently, then I want to tell you what your options are. So I can't tell you what your options are, and I can't advise you properly unless I own one and I physically live with it. So it's something that I've had vinyl cutters. I have Silhouette Cameos for years, guys, for years. And I've been cutting vinyl for a long time, so it was only natural for me to be able to step it up a notch and see what the more commercial stuff things are out there. And this is supposed to be, I guess, the top of the line. You guys correct me if I'm wrong in the comment section. This is supposed to be top of the line vinyl cutter. So yeah, I got it. We're definitely going to have to look at the instructions on this. Downloaded the software on my PC. Put in my serial numbers and everything, activation code and everything like that. You guys see what's included in it. Got some different pieces of equipments right here. You guys saw the blades. You guys saw me put together a stand. So that's what you have to look forward to if you purchase yours. And you guys have the instruction right here, because I showed you how to put the stand together and how to attach the cutter to the stand, guys. It's initially, when I first opened up the box, it looked intimidating, but it really wasn't. It was pretty much straightforward. The instruction manual, the illustration, perfect. There's no way you can screw it up unless you're just not good at putting things together. So this is an excellent start. You know, don't know anything about it, haven't had any experience with it. I've seen people use it before, but I've never used it before. So now it's my turn, and I'm gonna share all the information with you guys as I learn, guys, and let you guys know if it's something that you should consider if you are cutting vinyl on a regular basis. To the best of my knowledge, it's supposed to cut extremely faster, so I think I'm gonna enjoy it. But, you know, we'll see, guys. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this unboxing. I tried to get you guys some close-ups and stuff like that. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Give me a thumbs up if you did. Subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already. And, guys, I just want to tell you guys, just because I have that DTG printer, let me tell you a story, right? So I had to do 7 Disney shirts today, right? 7 Disney shirts for a client today. I got the order like 2 days ago. So I did them. I knocked them all out. They were supposed to be DTG, but they ended up being vinyl. Why? Because the Disney, you know, if you guys are familiar with the Disney shirts, they're like just white shirts with the ears and the castle in the middle, and you might put the name and a vacation or whatever on there. But I did all the shirts. Ended up doing them vinyl because my DTG, my Ricoh RI-1000, did not want to print out black text on the white shirt. It kept on doing that weird message again, with where it was telling me I was out of ink. I kept on getting that weird message again. But lo and behold, so that kind of had me like down last night, because that's when it started happening, like yesterday afternoon to last night. I stayed up to like ridiculous time in the morning trying to figure this out, like 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock or something like that. Couldn't figure it out, went to sleep, woke back up, or came back down here like 10 o'clock and tried to figure it out. Still wouldn't print, so I ended up doing the whole job in vinyl. Explained to the customer what happened, showed him the error message, and she was fine. Everything is good. She got her shirts. Everybody's happy. But now, another guy paid me for his order, and his order had to be DTG. The graphic had to be DTG. So I was able to, I said, let me just try it. And I tried it, full color, printed with no problem. I don't know if the DTG doesn't like to print black ink for me. I don't know. Just black text. I don't know what it is, guys. But I have a piece coming in the mail, and I am going to change out the carriage. The black carriage holds black and cyan, right? So I have to. It's just one screw that I remove, take it out, put in a new one, screw it back in, and hopefully we never have that error again. But I definitely need that to be fixed, because I think that regular black text on a white shirt background, that's like the most basic thing. And the DTG machine should be able to do it, even though it's something easy to do in vinyl. But, you know, it's easier to do for like one shirt on a DTG machine. It's like super, super easy. So like you just put the shirt down, pre-treat it, and it's easier. You know, you don't have to make the graphic, weed it, and all. It's just easier. You can take it. Yeah, it's easier to do with DTG. But anyway, guys, that's the update. Had to update you guys on the Ricoh. But like I said, it's working right now, full color print. I don't know what's going on with it. It's like it doesn't want to print what it doesn't want to print. So, and that's not good for business. And I tell you guys a story to tell you, like, when you are upgrading your equipment, never under any circumstances do you get rid of Old Faithful. Or the thing that's gotten you to the point that you are right now, you shouldn't get rid of it, because, correct me if I'm wrong, guys, and I know I'm not wrong because I'm telling you guys from experience, when stuff hits the fan and everything stops working, you always go back to what works. And what works is a Silhouette Cameo and a heat press. 101, vinyl garment decorating 101, Silhouette Cameo, and the heat press never fails. All right, never fails. Or you know, if you use a Cricut maker and a heat press, never fails. All right, so never get rid of your old vinyl cutter. You see, I have three Silhouette Studios here, and I got two at the other house. I got one in Dominica. Listen, never get rid of what works. All right, so I just want to tell you guys that real fast, because if I'd have got rid of my cameos, because you know, I got a DTG big stuff, I'd have been screwed on the shop, all right? So, yeah, thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to visit the merch store. I'm going to be putting a bunch of DTG shirts up slowly but surely. I'm going to make videos on them. And as I make videos on them, I'll put them in the store. I'll, like, take a little screenshot or whatever, and I'll put it in the store. Nothing fancy, no fancy pictures and stuff. But I am working to make my store look better, more legit, more of a commercial type of store. You guys will see while it's in progress. AlanAWade.com. Watch it now. and see what it becomes. AlanAway.com. Watch it now and see what it becomes, okay? So I'll talk to you guys on the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, A-Dubb Productions. Follow me on Facebook, A-Dubb Productions. Follow me on, time for me to press the shirt that I just did to dry it. Don't forget to follow me on TikTok, A-Dubb Productions. And I'll talk to you guys on the next video, guys. Peace.